Let me look into this. This is a very big chapter. But anyway, see, man takes 3 hours and 45 minutes to row a boat for 15 kilometers. See, as you read, you have to write a diagram. 15 kilometer, 15 kilometer, the distance. And he takes time. What is the time? 3 hour, 45 minutes, and take 2 hour 30 minutes to cover a distance of 5 meter. See, the distance are not same. Therefore, he has a different distance. This is S1, T1. S2 is how much? He covers a distance of 5 kilometer. See, this is what? 3 hour 45 minutes boat in downstream. Downstream means velocity of the downstream, right? Velocity of downstream. You have to this direction. And here, and 2 hours 30 minutes. That means T2 is what? 2 hours 30 minutes to cover the distance of 5 kilometer. In the upstream, upstream means this direction. That means velocity of the upstream. Find the speed of the river. Find the speed of the river current. That means what is VC they ask. They can add. Find the velocity of the swimmer also they can ask you. If at all they ask you the same. This you know already. What is velocity of the? First here. Before doing all that, you do the conversion. Here, hour and minute. See, 60 minute equal to 1 hour. 30 minute equal to half an hour. 15 minute equal to quarter hour. Then 45 minute is what? 45 minutes 30 plus 15, half plus quarter. That means 3/4 of hour, right? You know this. Therefore, what is T1 here? T1 is equal to 3/45 is what? 3/4 of the hour. Understood? That means 12 is mixed fraction. Therefore, 12 plus 3, 15. 15 by 4 hour. Therefore, T1 is equal to 15 by 4 hour. You are done. Time I know. Similarly, I can do T2. T2 is what? What is T2? 2 hour, 2 and half hour. 2 2s of 4 plus 1, 5 by 2 hour. T2 is what? 5 by 2 hour. What is velocity of downstream? Velocity of downstream is equal to distance by time, is it not? What is the distance? 15 kilometer. What is the time? Here, this is distance. S1, T1. S1 is what? 15 divided by time is 15 by 4. This goes up. This one get cancelled. 4. Therefore, V downstream is equal to 4 kilometer per hour downstream. Then what is velocity upstream? That means velocity upstream is equal to again distance by time. Distance by time. How much distance to cover? See, it is easy to go along, but against the wave, it's very difficult. Right? Takes so much time. So much time to cover only 5. Here, very less time to cover 15. Right? Right? Therefore, here, what is S2? S2 is equal to 5 kilometer by T2 is what? 5 by 2. This one, cancel, this goes up 2. Therefore, what is V upstream? 2 kilometer per hour. Now we have done this particular sum. What is velocity of the current? They are asking find the velocity of river current. The velocity of the river or velocity of the river current is equal to half velocity of the downstream minus velocity of the upstream. Is it not? That is how much? Half velocity of the downstream is 4, up is 2. That means what? Half 2, it is 1. Therefore, velocity of the current is equal to 1 kilometer per hour. This velocity of the river. This velocity of the river. And what is, see, this you know the formula. Again, velocity of the man or swimmer is equal to velocity m is equal to what? Half into velocity of the downstream plus velocity of the upstream divided by 2. That is half. This is how much? 2. Sorry. Downstream 4. Upstream is 2. Therefore 6 by 2. 3. Therefore velocity of the man or swimmer is equal to 3 kilometer per hour. I think you became perfect in this topic. You start going through different books, go through the different videos and YouTube, and all the sums you have to do in 2-3 minutes. Believe it or not, I have taken so much time to do this. Youngsters like you people, right? It can take you, what is it, not even 2-3 minutes. It took nearly half an hour for me to understand and all that. Right? Therefore, you can do that. Keep practicing it. And become a very dignified person in the society. Jai Hind.